By now, everyone's pretty much saw what happened last night during the debate. There are three parts of that debate that I really want to touch on that Donald Trump completely destroyed himself on. The first is obviously the immigration. Now, here's a small clip of Joe Biden pretty much scolding him on his immigration policy that has separated kids from their parents, and not to mention Donald Trump's third grade response to it.
Parents were ripped, their kids were ripped from their arms and separated. It's criminal.
They are so well taken care of. They're in facilities that were so clean.
They're being so well taken care of? That's your response. They should be with their families, their parents. That's your response. I don't know where to start with this guy on that. I really don't. It's becoming more and more embarrassing by the second. But the second part I really want to touch on, obviously, is the coronavirus. Now, Trump keeps screaming that there's going to be a vaccine ready sometime before the election or sometime after the election, mainly because he's going to be reelected. There's going to be a vaccine. There's going to be a vaccine. Listen to this. Joe, take him to church.
What happened? What did the president say? He said, don't worry. It's going to go away. Be gone by Easter. Don't worry. The warm weather. Don't worry. Maybe inject bleach. He said he was kidding when he said that, but a lot of people thought it was serious.
You know you're lying, right, Trump? You know you are lying. You know damn well what you said. But in case you're too stupid and you think you have the best memory, which you don't, here's what you said.
And then I see the disinfectant where it knocks it out in a minute, 1 minute. And is there a way we can do something like that by injection inside or almost a cleaning?
But the third thing I really want to talk about, honestly, oh man, just listen to this.
I am the least racist person in this room.
Well, what do you say to Americans who are concerned by that rhetoric?
I don't know.
I don't know
what to say. I got criminal justice reform done and prison reform and opportunity zones. I took care of black colleges and universities. I don't know what to say. They can say anything. I mean, they can say anything. It makes me sad because I am the least racist person. I can't even see the audience because it's so dark. But I don't care who's in the audience. I'm the least racist person in this room.
Okay, Vice President Biden, let me...
You're the least racist person. The least racist person. Why? Because you gave money to colleges? Because you wrote some bill that no law enforcement agency is going to take seriously? You're a racist, Trump. We know this. We know that you're a racist. Not once have you addressed systemic racism. In fact, you have said to yourself and your people in your regime have said that systemic racism doesn't exist. You're lying, Trump. You are a racist. You are a racist. But I love how Joe Biden just gives this guy a smack in the face.
Let me ask you very quickly, and then I have a follow-up question for you.
Abraham Lincoln here is one of the most racist presidents we've had in modern history. He pours fuel on every single racist fire, every single one. Started off his campaign coming down the escalator saying he's going to get rid of those Mexican rapists. He's banned Muslims because they're Muslims. He has moved around and made everything worse across the board. He says about the poor boys, last time we were on stage here, he said, I told him to stand down and stand ready. Come on. This guy is a dog whistle about as big as a foghorn.
Trump, you're not going to win this election. And even if you do win by some miracle of the devil, because it's not going to be God that miracle that gets you reelected. If you are somehow reelected and put back in the office, this country is going to die. And you're not going to be around to see it because, like all cowards, you will run. How I think I'm willing to bet dollars to donuts that you that you have the plane, jet, and fueled and ready to go in case you lose this election, in case you actually get caught with the crap that you've been shown, that you've been rumored that you've done. Because you're a coward, Trump. You've never been in a fight in your life. I don't think it's in you to be a fighter. I think it's been in you to be a runner. There are fighters and there are runners. You're the runner. Because quite honestly, it's shown every day of your life, thanks to your niece, which I should reread the book actually, because it was that good. But the second reason is because of your presidency. You've shown me in the 4 years that you were president that you have no balls. You have no guts for a true fight. You're a boy trying to pretend to be a man in a man's game. You haven't learned from an early age that every action you take has a consequence. Whether we know what those consequences are, or we actually just pretend we don't know what they are. The truth of the matter is, you haven't learned that lesson. And I would take pity on you, but I hope to see you fail. See, 12 years ago, this should be corrected, Rush Limbaugh, the guy who's dying of cancer, hoped that Barack Obama would fail. Not because he was a Democrat, but because he was black. I'm hoping you fail, because if you fail, it means lives will be saved. You failed during the coronavirus pandemic. 220,000 men, women, and children are dead because of you. Americans are dead because of you. If it were up to me, I would arrest your ass right now. Get in my car, drive up to Washington or wherever the hell you are right now trying to campaign, and have your ass arrested. But I'm going to do even better. See, earlier this week, I voted against you. I'm going to continue to speak out against you even after this election is over with, even if Joe Biden is elected. I'm going to continue to speak out against you, because I am honestly not going to let you get away with the crap you've done in the last 4 years. And last night's debate was a joke on your part, not Joe Biden's. He answered the questions and he talked to the people. You were doing all this. I'm going to do all this. You're not talking to us, Trump. You're talking at us. And I know your supporters are already arming themselves, getting them ready for some kind of revolutionary war to get you back in the White House. It's not going to work. To the Trump supporters, I say this. Put the guns down, because you're going to lose, and lose badly. Don't die for this man. Do not kill for this man. He won't appreciate it. And all you're going to be doing is destroying yourselves in the process. Don't do it. Don't. He's not worth it. I'm CTP, Know the Truth. God bless. Peace to the left, justice to the right. Save our nation.